All of our competitors paired up in their positions, ready to go. Plenty of teammates still alive between these guys. Though Elohim and Clam Taco seem to be heading in an alternate direction, we may see something between Itmi JP, Strippin', Sacriel, and Break soon if they continue to hang out in these same tree lines together.
Like, even though we're just doing something as simple as just trying to get blood back, it's stressful, because all I'm thinking is Break could just shout, "Guy next to you!" Like, and there could be a guy just charge up with an axe and smash me in the face. So now I've got my water up. I'm going to eat this rice until I get my energy.
Are they like people-specific messages?
Yeah, so like,
so if... can someone just send me? Like, because if someone says, "Break and Sacriel, please get into the zone," is everyone going to see that?
Yeah,
because
probably.
Then it'd be like, all right, everyone
yeah, but there's
knows
a massive,
that.
There's a massive zone, so people will just go, oh, they're near the edge somewhere. I doubt they'll be
yeah.
like... No, there's like
yeah, no,
thousands.
I know where they are.
There's like 10,000 meters of zone.
It looks like we have... 5 minutes, phase two will be in play, and you must be in the proper phase or face disqualification. So these players are all going to be pushing that direction, and this is where we could see some more PvP erupt. These players are going to be pushing towards phase two, as we saw on our map, and we'll show again right now. The elongated circle that leads up towards the Northwest Airfield. All of these players are going to be moving from where they are here in these cities and these northern wooden areas, heading in this direction over here and preparing to move to the airfield. Again, we may see some players move into Cabanino for food, water, the things they may need, but I'm assuming more than anything, because there's not a lot of that here, we're going to see a lot of these players holding up and trying to transition into the airfield area, where most of them will probably feel a lot more comfortable.
I need you on point, because if we get shot at and I take the first round, I'm dead. I'll almost exclusively look back. If you want.
Left is a big one.
Yeah. I'm looking back.
This is,
I'm looking
we,
left
we
and then back.
We could get ambushed here. Alright, we're... Okay,
this is danger zone. We're on the border.
Yeah. Yeah, we're fine. Player, left eye. Two players.
Fuck. Are you still enough to ambush them if they don't do longs? Like, wait, see if they break to come towards our tree line or something. But don't.
Oh, they're good. They're both.
Fuck.
Both got guns.
Maybe we should stalk them until they get in a fight and maybe try and engage them from behind.
Keep an eye on our left.
Yeah. I'm so stressed, guys. I'm so stressed. At least my colour's coming back. You see the greens now? So we're well on our way to colour recovery, but I've got a broken arm, low health, no armour.
Surely Temple, that they've added some fucking tent somewhere. Like, because phase two, apart from Cabs, like, barren, right?
Yeah, there must be tent. There
must
be.
Can't go into Grish.
There must be extra shit here. Like, we only looted a couple of shitty places and got loads of stuff. Well, not loads of stuff, but like, a CZ with a mag and you got all that ammo for a repeater. God knows what fucking gear these guys have got if they went in the middle of story.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I'm fully blooded now. I just don't have any health. But we need to play it smart. Like, we can either try and win or we can try and get kills but die.
I think we need to keep going, because the two come across the road, they could push us. So top of this hill in front of us, pine trees right at the top, yeah. Is their last known, running from left to right.
Can I get that pickaxe so I've got a melee, in case I need to start clonking a bitch?
Yeah, you got no melee? Yeah.
I've got like a small pickaxe, but I think your big pickaxe does more damage. It's like a two-hand axe, right?
Yeah, take that as well. Shotgun. You fit it in your backpack?
Yeah. This is so fucking scary, oh my god.
Shots.
There is.
You hear that?
No. Well, shots. South trees?
Directly across from us. Yeah.
Whoa, game freeze.
Two Mosin shots, that was.
Spaced or ba-bang? Because that's a bug.
Don't know.
I could do with a fucking Mosin right now. Although my aim's shaky because I've got a broken arm and I'm cold. So you're wondering about actually going into cab?
I don't know. Just don't. They beat us to the airfield. They're probably going to beat us to the barracks, and you've not got a weapon.
This is really developing very quickly. With Sacriel on break, still out in the open, got a lot of cover, and armed to the teeth and just waiting.
Yeah, you can tell that they have their eyes on the tree lines up ahead. They want to head into that position. They want to be ready for the transition into phase three. They're preparing for it, but they're very, very smart players. Very smart. They're taking their time, doing whatever they need to do to ensure their safety and that they get there no problem.
Oh fuck, there's a dead guy in this open field.
Might have bled out, might have, who knows. I should probably try
to
and loot
check
him.
His fucking body.
I have no choice. I'll go stand at it and then bait a shot, see what happens. Wish me luck, guys. This is where I die.
Someone might still be in mouth, dude.
Looks like Break and Sacriel closing in very, very quickly on Itmi, JP, and Strippin.
Shit, there's two people with full gear. Well, not full gear, but gear. Like a Mosin and shit. Oh my god, I need that Mosin. Is that a Mosin?
Where?
The two people I'm on about. Yeah, these two people.
They're dead?
Yeah.
Oh shit, man.
Okay, just stood still for a few seconds and baited a shot. Didn't get anything.
Possibly, it looks like they're both passed out.
Yeah,
possibly due
right
to
now.
Exhaustion, not having enough food and water. Sacriel has noticed. He is inspecting things right now.
I wish I knew what happened here. I'm really baffled as to how this occurred. It looks like...
looks like they went Sacriel out together.
Tentatively looking at their bodies, but trying to keep mobile at the same time. Not wanting to stand still. With Break covering him from the tree line about 150 meters out.
Can you access him?
Yeah.
Sick! Bring everything!
They didn't have much, but I've got bandages enough to make a splint, and I've got...
your overlay?
It's fine.
Okay.
I've got enough... Are you in mouth?
Yeah.
I got enough to make my
you
splint.
You got any weapons?
I got a new CZ, but no ammo. I've got two mags.
Alright, well that's better than picking the balls.
Yeah, I need to make the splint and fix my arm up.
Go for it.
I need you to like be looking in, not just out, but in as well.
I'm looking in, I'm not looking out. If we're getting killed from out, it's from 400 meters away and there's nothing we can do about it.
Yeah. That's Break down there, guys. You can see him in blue.
Get behind the down tree in the middle.
I'm good.
You fix your arm up, yeah?
No, I'm fixing it already, so I don't want to move. Shit, is that... oh, is that you? Yeah.
You red motorbike helmet
Yeah.
You scrub.
Okay, my arm's fixed. Splitting my bandages four ways.
Okay.
One.
How many bandages have you got?
One, two, three, four. Do you want one?
You want to make two splints? Just real quick now.
I'm going to have to find more sticks. One sec. This is the survival part of DayZ, guys. This is the crawling around trying to stay alive part.
Shit. Is he at that rock?
Yeah, he's looking around. He's aiming a gun at me! Dude,
he's got
get
a
eyes.
Fucking gun?
I don't know. It looks like it. Get eyes. Shots. Okay. Pistol. Oh, fuck it. I might just go and whack him with a hammer.
No, don't do that.
Well, I'm keeping his attention. Shit, he's pushing
is
me.
That you?
He's pushing
me.
Yeah. Let me sit in the back, let's see if this works.
Zombies!